Hello everyone, my name is Ashish and welcome to the XAdmin channel. And today we are going to discuss about the Java program on Factorial using a recursion, right? So guys, what is recursion? A recursion in Java is a process in which a method calls itself continuously, and a method in Java that calls itself is called as a recursive method. Okay, so guys, recursion in Java is a process in which a method calls itself continuously, and a method in Java that calls itself is called as a recursive method, and it makes the code compact but complex to understand, right? So guys, a recursion is basically divided into two cases. First is the base case and second is the general case. In base case, it stops the function to call itself when a specific condition matches. So guys, in base case we define the condition, and if the condition get satisfy or matches, then the function stops its call. Okay, and guys, there can be any number of the base cases in Java program of the recursion, and in the general case it calls the function from within that function, right? So guys, actually the recursion is a process in which a method calls itself continuously till the time the base case condition get unsatisfied, right? So now guys, we are going to see the next problem. And guys, the above three problems we have discussed in the last lecture, like to print a number from any number to one. And guys, also we have find the number of eyes of the person we have passed in a function. And guys, also we have find the power of the any number. Okay, and guys, today we are going to see a program or write a program to find the factorial of an any number using a recursion method. So let's go to our IDE, and guys, we are going to write a program for the recursion. So guys, for that I am going to create a separate Java class. So let's create a Java class, and I'm going to name this Java class as a factorial. Factorial recursion. Okay. Factorial recursion. And guys, inside this factorial recursion, firstly I will create a main method. So let's create a main method quickly. Public static void main, and inside the main method we will pass the string argument. Okay, and guys, we have created a main method. And guys, inside the main method I'm going to write a logic for the factorial using a recursion process. So guys, for that guys, firstly I will create a method. Okay, so guys, now I am going to create a method which will find, or it will actually calculate the factorial of any number. So let's create a method, public void, and the method name I am going to keep as a calculate fact. Okay, and inside this method, okay, and now guys, I have created a method which will find the factorial of any number. And now let's declare a variable. Okay, and now let's declare the number of which we want to find the factorial. So inside the main method I'm going to declare a number in which I'm going to store the number which we want to find the factorial. So int num, and guys, I am storing 5 in it. Okay, so int num equals to 5. And now I am going to create a object of this class. Okay, so let's create the object factorial recursion equals to new factorial. And guys, with the help of this object I am going to call the calculate fact method. So let's call the calculate fact method with the object factorial dot calculate fact. Okay, and now guys, I am going to pass the parameter of a method as the number. So let's pass the number here as a num. Okay, and now guys, inside this method I am going to receive the number which we are passing by calling the method. Okay, so let's receive this number, and I'm going to declare the variable as a integer type of num. And guys, here the num will receive the number which will be passed to find the factorial. And now guys, I'm going to write the base. Okay, and now I'm going to write the base case. So let's write the base case inside the calculate fact method. So guys, my base case will be, it will inside the calculate fact, let's write if condition. And guys, inside the if condition I'm going to do if num value is greater than or equals to 1. Okay, if num value is equals to or greater than 1. So guys, here guys it will invoke or it will call the function itself until or unless the condition matches. And guys, inside this condition, okay, so guys before that, okay, so guys before that I am going to define one fact variable as a static. So let's create a fact variable as a static int fact equals to 1. Okay, and inside our the if condition I am going to calculate. Okay, and now guys, I am going to let's calculate fact equals to fact. Okay, fact into num, right? So guys, this fact equals to fact into num. And guys, after this I am going to call the calculate fact method itself. So let's call the calculate fact method, and inside the parameter of the calculate fact method we have to decrement the value of the num by 1 every time it calls the method. So num minus 1. Okay, and guys, till here we have written the concept of how to calculate the factorial of any number. And guys, here guys I am using the recursive method, because the calculate fact method is calling its method again and again, and guys, it is going to call this method continuously till the condition is matched. Okay, and now guys, let's print the factorial of a number to show the result of the factorial. So I am going to the main method, and after this line I am going to print the result of the factorial. So let's put SOP here, and inside the SOP let's write some text, factorial of, and I am taking the num of which I want to find, like is, and let's put some space. And after this guys, I am going to write the fact. So now guys, I'm going to run this program, and I'm going to check that whether we are getting the factorial of the 5 in a console or not. Okay, and after that I will explain the program. So let's run this program, and guys, here we can see that we are getting the factorial of 5 as 120. And now let's calculate the factorial of value 3, and let's rerun this program. And guys, here we can see that we are getting the factorial of 3 as 6. Okay, so now guys, see here guys, first the int of the fact is like 1, and inside the main method we are keeping the value, the num, as num equals to 3. And now guys, we are creating the object of this factorial recursion, and with the object of this factorial recursion class, we are going to call the calculate fact method. And guys, inside the calculate fact method, we are going to pass the num value, and here the num value is 3. So guys, the num value will be received by this num, and guys, it is going to check the condition. So guys, here it's fine that 3 is greater than 1. Yes, 3 is greater than 1. So guys, it will go inside the if condition, and guys, inside the if condition, it is going to store the fact into num value. So guys, here the fact is 1. So guys, 1 into num, and guys, the num is like 3. So guys, here it is going to store the fact equals to, so let's put a comment here, and guys, here the fact will be like 3, okay, because guys, fact is 1 and the num is 3. So num, so guys, 1 into 3 is like 3, and guys, here it is going to store the fact as 3. And now guys, after the this, it is going to call the method itself, and here it is calling the calculate fact method, and here guys, it is passing the num minus 1. So guys, till now the num was like 3, and now guys, the num equals to 2, okay, 3 minus 1 equals to 2. So guys, it will go to this method, it will call to this method, and here the num will receive the 2 value. And guys, again it is going to check the condition if the num is greater than or equals to 1. So guys, here the num is greater than equals to 1, it means guys, 2 is greater than 1. Yes guys, it is true, and it will go inside the if condition. It is going to calculate the fact value. So guys, the fact was like 3, and 3 into num, and the num is like 2. So guys, the 3 into 2 is like 6. So guys, it is going to store the 6 value to the fact. And now guys, it is going to call again the method itself, and guys, in now the num minus will be done. So num is like 1, so now the nums become 1, okay. So now the num becomes 1, and guys, it is going to call this method again, and guys again it is going to check the condition, and guys, here it's found that 1 is greater than or equals to 1, and okay. So now guys, it will go inside the if condition, and guys, it will do the calculation as fact into num. It means that 6, okay, fact is 6 and num is 1. So guys, 6 into 1 is like 1, sorry, 6 into 1 is like 6. So guys, here the 6 will be stored to the fact, okay. And now guys, again it is going to call the method itself, and now the num will be like 0, because the num was 1. So 1 minus 1 is it will be 0. And guys, again it will call this method, and inside this method it will receive the num value as 0. And now guys, condition will be checked as the 0 is greater than or equals to 1. So guys, here the condition get false, and guys, it will go outside the if condition, and guys, here it will go again, and guys, here it will print the output as the factorial of the num, as the 3 is like 6, okay, as guys we can see in our console, okay. So guys, in this guys, we have written a program to find the factorial by using a recursion method. And guys, we can make this code a more smaller or a compact code, okay. So let's do it guys. So guys, for that I am going to create the separate class for this, and I will copy the same code and I will edit wherever it is required to make it smaller, okay. Factorial, let's keep the name factorial recursion 2, and now let's copy the whole program from here, and then after that I will do the editing wherever it is required. So I have copied this program and I am pasting inside our new class of the factorial recursion 2, and let's edit this, okay. and here let's make the object as 2 and let's paste the class name here and let's change the object by which it is calling the calculate fact. Okay, and now guys I am going to simply return the calculation from here directly. Okay, so guys I hope it will save. Okay, so now guys let's return directly, and before that I am going to remove this void and I am going to keep it as int. Okay, and now guys inside the if condition, okay, inside the if condition I have to change the code. So let's write directly return the calculation. So guys we have to do like num, okay, num into, and we have to call the calculate fact, and inside the calculate fact I have to do the num minus 1 value. Okay, and okay guys, and guys inside the if condition I am returning the calculation of the factorial directly, and I have made this calculate fact as integer type. So guys after the if condition I have to return one more statement here, and let's return here 1. Okay, and here I am returning 1, and guys and now I am removing this static integer fact, and after removing that I am going to create one instance variable of the fact. So let's create one instance variable. So guys here I have created a fact variable inside the main method. Okay, and now guys I am going to store the return value of this calculation to the fact. Okay, so guys here I have done the fact equals to factorial recursive to object dot calculate fact method, and guys it is going to return the value, and guys it is going to store the calculation of the factorial to the fact variable, and guys we are going to do the SOP and we are going to print the value of the factorial. So let's run this program and let's check the output we are getting or not. So guys we can see that we got the output as same as the factorial of 3 is 6. So let's change the number and let's make it 4 and let's compile the program and let's check the output. So guys we can see that we are getting the output as 24. Okay, so guys in this we have implemented a factorial logic by the help of the recursion process. Okay guys, thank you and have a nice day, and see you in the next lecture of the recursion. Thank you.